Hello, welcome back to Onward. So I made a mistake in my other video and I just didn't have enough time to do it. So to actually get Zorn's backpack, and I'll show you the location again in case you didn't know or you didn't see my other video. So that's the docks, the hive, the vigil pylon, and of course the temple of the Cabal of the Wind, some ruins. So you can guess how much time you need to get here. And then you just have to go to the right. And of course I cleared all the enemies, so it will be a very very easy path. I guess I'm doing this because I'm tired of all these trees that are always looking the same for me. And maybe people have the same problem with the forest looking the same all over. So yeah, you go straight up to here. As you can see, there is the Royal Manticore up there. It's kind of a hard fight if you're not prepared for it or if you don't have the endgame armor. Or at least your faction armor like I'm having. And then you can just go to its nest. By the way, you can just skip it if you don't feel like fighting it, but it will drop the Star Child Claymore and of course materials for your dagger or your great mace, the Manticore dagger or great mace, which I'm using right now. It looks very poisonous. So yeah, to actually get Zorn's backpack, you need the large emerald, which is a stupid thing. Because I didn't know you need one, so yeah, that's why I didn't have time to get it in my other video. But hey, this is better because now I can make a single video for it. So clearing up this Manticore lair and full of troglodytes will need about 20 minutes or so. You need bandages among some other stuff. This looks like a human design. You need bandages, as I said. A lot of them. Now, there is, should be another trap in here, okay? Just enter through here. Go to the right. And just follow this path up. Now, there will be a lot of combat, so yeah, be careful. This is the Palladium node. Then you'll go to the Troglodyte village, which is weird because I want to learn more about them and their customs because they seem like a really large tribe or a faction of the game. And they seem to turn to stone and they seem to eat meat or something really weird. Anyway, pass this village, kill all the troglodytes, or they will kill you. And then you reach their small ceremony chamber. So I guess this door needed a large ruby. Needed a medium ruby, I think, or a small sapphire to open. It has only the trog chest, which... not so good. Not so good at all. They look so weird made out of stone like that. And Zorn's backpack is actually in the other room. For which you need a large emerald. So, yeah, I'll be carrying this all the time with me because of this. Did I drop it? No. So see, that's a large emerald. You need this for the door. And then you come up to here and look at all the poor troglodytes and then you see something special in here. What could it be? To be honest, I think Zorn's hunting backpack is the best backpack in the game. Well, this is the largest backpack because it has 110. But let's just equip it and you'll see why, what I mean. Besides looking cool, looking very very cool and making you look like... hold on a second. And making you look like a... like a true warlord, it also has the benefit of having 85 slots, which is decent. It's not very big, but it's decent. It doesn't slow you down and it decreases your stamina cost by an extra 10%. So yeah, this means you can run a lot. You can run a lot more ground. I mean, if you compare it, let's say the bed will give you minus 20%. So the backpack gives you minus 10% stamina usage. So you can run, I mean you can sprint almost two maps right now, at least with my current build. But you don't, if you don't have the speed build, you can at least run a whole map. Because you'll also have the marathoner, which will make your sprinting consume 40% less stamina, which means with your sun it will be minus 50%. And of course with some food and some other buffs it will be way way lower than that. So 85 slots are enough to bring you can bring potions, you can bring weapon enhancements, some other stuff, and you still have enough room to get some loot. Yeah, but I still prefer using the Merfino's backpack because I use a lot of potions. Hold on, let me see. There was an option to hide the UI. By the way, that's for the reshade mod I'm using. If you see something writing on the top of the screen. Yeah, this looks so nice. Oh, if this backpack had 15 more weight to it, I would just use it all the time. It's so cool. I wonder what... Are these thieves? Or are they claws? What are they? I'm curious now. They could be claws. Or tusks? Who knows? Anyway, this is the easy way to get the backpack, and besides, you can skip the Royal Manticore fight, but you'll have to fight the Manticore. Actually, you can skip almost everything, but if you do that, the Troglodytes will just swarm you in here, and you have to get back all the way to exit. Oh, and another thing, if you don't know how to pick it up and put it in your backpack, you just open it, and you stake all. Now it's in our backpack. The backpack is in our backpack. Very short and easy video. So now I have some of the unique backpacks. I still have some to collect. But we are getting there. Bye.